Gentlemen, today is Friday, which means it's time for more stupid, funny, crazy news, a weekly series where I break down the top news stories fitting in the categories of stupid, funny, and crazy. As you can see, I have a new intro. Made that today. I saw it on, it was something kind of like it on TrollArc office site, so I was like, hey, I kind of want to try that. So I did. But anyways, last week's winners was the Rape Fruit Funny and the Crazy $100,000 sex doll. Remember, at the end of the video, I will put up annotations. Pick the one which you thought was the best story of the week. So let's get into the news. Starting out with a stupid story. Turns out masturbating on St. Patrick's Day is a real leprechaun. Authorities in St. Paul, Minnesota. Oh, stay classy. Second week in a row with a story from the great state of Minnesota. Hey? Well, authorities in St. Paul learned Saturday afternoon Steve Young, I'm thinking it's not the same as Steve Young, the football player, was sitting on the sidewalk openly masturbating, according to the criminal complaint obtained by City Pages. Allegedly, St. Paddy's Day whacker told a security guard that he was just picking at a scab on his penis. And when police showed up, they asked him what he was doing, and he responded, "Something I'm not supposed to be doing." Then he allegedly told cops that not only had he had been drinking since 11 a.m., he had also been smoking methamphetamine for 3 to 4 days. When police informed him that he'd be arrested, he was extremely surprised, saying that he wasn't doing anything wrong. He was just picking at a pesky scab. He was charged with criminal sexual conduct and indecent exposure. So I guess a little pro tip of the day, don't do meth. Or if you are going to do meth, don't masturbate on a city curb. That's my advice to all you out there. Well, let's move on to the funny news. Austin Whaley was arrested after busting into a bingo hall in Kentucky filled with elderly women and yelling bingo, and the hall erupted in chaos. When they realized it wasn't a real bingo, they started hooting and hollering and yelling and cursing. It's a badass old women. They're serious about their bingo. Some little punk ass kid's gonna fuck up their bingo? No! They're not standing for that. And he was arrested. He refused to apologize, actually, and was arrested on disorderly conduct. Instantly, the officers grabbed his hand, handcuffed him, and took him into the cruiser. This is what Wiley was telling NBC. He faces up to $90 in jail and $250 in fines for the offense. So, it's kind of funny, actually. These old ladies getting into their bingo. Oh my god. I'm surprised they didn't start throwing punches. I can imagine a bunch of old ladies fighting people. But anyways, moving on, last story. Crazy-ass news of the day. Police in Texas had to break up a fight of two women after one woman ripped out the eyeball of the other woman. That shit cray. Anyways, Talisha Morrison. I'm Talisha Morrison. Blah, blah, blah. About 3 or 4 of you out there is going to get that, but for those of you who get that, haha. Anyways, they told police that she dug her fingers into the woman's skull and tore out the eye. God, ow. How crazy you have to be to do that? I'd just be like, I'm going to take your eye out. Anyways, the victim was 22 years old. Morrison was 20 years old. God, that's a tough age to lose an eyeball at 22. I guess no age is really good to lose an eyeball, I should say. But 22, that you saw a lot of life left. Saw that, yeah. Anyways, Morrison was arrested on aggravated assault. It's unclear who actually started the fight. Well, anyways, guys, those are the 3 stories. Remember, click the annotations you see above, picking which one is the best. I'll reveal the winner next week. Members, likes, favorites, and subscribe if you're new around here are always appreciated. I'm out.